Howdy, hi, everyone. Hey, come on in if you want to check out some good vegan, vegetarian, whole foods, plant-based cooking that's going to be good for your body, good for your health, good for the planet. Oh, and my doctor told me, no oils. So come on in if you want to check out a healthier way of eating. I got some great food for you. Come on.
Take 2,399.
Howdy, boys and girls. This here is my review unboxing of the Instant Pot. Check the link down below. I'll show you where I got mine. I saved a few bucks by buying a refurbished one or a factory second. This one here is a scratch and dent with the emphasis on dent. The box arrived undamaged, but there was a nice dent on the Instant Pot itself. Everything worked out fine. I understand it's kind of common with these here to get a dent in the side, but this one here looked like it got kicked by a government mule. Inside of the Instant Pot, you've got your rice cup. Watch out, that little sumbitch, it just went flying on me there. And you see the ladle and the rice spatula. That little cup is for measuring your rice. You got your warning stuff. Hey, be sure and read your manual there. These things can be rather dangerous. You got high pressure in it and steam. You can burn yourself. There's a little trivet that goes in the bottom if you want to make like soy yogurt inside and the like. But hey, this bad boy works great for beans, and that's why I bought it, so I can save me a buck or two. And you can make you a batch of beans inside of an hour. No drying, no soaking. Just rinse them and throw them in. The stainless steel pot on the inside is pretty heavy duty. Looks like a nice one. That damn pot's going to outlast me. And there's my little dent we got there. I saw online that it's kind of common for these bad boys to get some dents in them. Not a big deal. It works fine. You can loosen the three screws on the bottom there and pull the bottom out and go in and beat it out if you want to. If not, hell, you can send it back. But I'm happy. Yeah, this is a little different than Granny's pressure cooker she had on the stovetop. You got your computer control, and it has a keep warm function. Let's go over the basic cooking of this here. You're going to plug it in. You're going to put all your goodies in. You don't want to put cold liquids in there. Preheat your liquids on your stovetop. Pour your hot liquids in there. Have everything ready to go. You got it plugged in. You're going to put your lid on it. Turn your lid to seal it. This is the pressure release valve. You want to make sure that that's set in the middle where it says sealing. Then you want to press the manual button there. Press the manual. This here is going to give you more control. You've got all your preset functions. I don't really care about that stuff. Press manual. Then you're going to press your plus or your minus buttons to set it for how much time you need. For me, my first batch cooking chili, I set it for 50 minutes. Give it about 10, 20 seconds. It'll then say on. Once it gets to temperature, it goes through. Let it sit for about 10 minutes. When you're done, slowly turn the venting lever to where it says venting. It's going to bleed off the pressure, and you're going to have you some good eating. Now take a look at this right here. This is a mess of some good chili that I made. I just hope I can keep making it time and time again. Check the recipe down below. I've got it on my blog. You can print it out. I guarantee it's going to stick to your ribs. Just look at that. I put some sun-dried tomatoes in it. Oh, I was in heaven. You're going to want to get you one of these, I promise.
Hey, and there you go. Some finger-licking good chili. Check the link down below for my blog. I'll show you the recipe, all that good stuff. Hey, I want to thank each and every one of you for watching. Y'all come back now, you hear?